Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session, we are going to focus on mainly three things. That is, first one is information system ethics and computer crime and the security. These three terms plays very important role in the nowadays, because all your digital India and all the transactions made by the peoples, okay, they need the security. The digital crime is going to increase, okay, in the upcoming days. So for that, understanding of these things is very important. So what are the outcomes of this is that after the session, you will be understand, okay, how the computer system ethics, okay, affects the information system. Okay, you will be able to understand the privacy, accuracy, property, accessibility, okay, which are the different types of computers, crimes, and the different types of the attacks, that is virus, worm, trojan horse, logic and thumb bomb, and all that things. And after that, you will be understood how to provide the security for this one. Okay, so we will start it learning one by one. First, we'll focus on the ethics. Okay, there is a standard rule. Okay, we said that TOFLAS three waves of to change. Okay, agriculture, industrial, and information age. In the every 5 years, it will be get doubled. Okay, this is the rule of the TOFLAS three waves of change. Okay, so as we know, the data which is available in the digital format is going to double in every 5 years. Okay, and with the term computer literacy means the people's actually knowing to how to handle the computer, and digital divide, it means the gap, okay, between the people who are computer literate and computer non-literate. Okay, so computer ethics is the standards, okay, of the conduction as they pertain to the use of information system. Okay, privacy means protecting someone's personal information from all the others. Okay, so actually the system needs the personal information, but they have to provide the assurity that it will be kept private. Okay, and in the case of the identity theft, what happens is that the stealing of another's social security number or the credit card number or the personal information is get theft. So this is the identity theft. Okay, and ethics is that information accuracy and deals with the authentication and fidelity of information. Okay, and information property means the deals, it deals with the owns of the information about the individual and how information can be sold or exchanged. Okay, so the legal author, otherwise legal owner, only have the access and privilege to handle with this. Okay, so this is the ethics. This is called the accessibility. Okay, that means it deals with the how the information a person the right to obtain about others and how the information can be used. Okay, and which are the issues in the information accessibility as the carnivore. Okay, ECP and monitoring emails like the need for a code of ethical conduct. Okay, information system ethics contains, okay, the need for a code of ethical conduct, business ethics, plagiarism, okay, cyber scouting. These are the various tools, and to using in one of them, okay, we can find out the particular data is the original content or the they are theft or the modified from getting it by the another source likewise. Okay, so this is need for a code of ethical conduct. Next, we are going to focus on the computer crime. Okay, so definition of this computer crime is that it is the act of using the computer to commit an illegal act. Okay, so it is authorized and unauthorized computer access means the proper owner should only gain the access to particular things, and if it is not done like that, then it may be get illegal act. okay, and whatever the action committed, like that is called as a crime. Okay, just few examples are the stealing time on company computers, breaking into the government websites and stealing someone's credit card information. These are all the types of the computer crime. Okay, so federal and state laws are the things are gaining unauthorized access, okay, stealing the data, violating data belongs to the bank, okay, intercepting communication, it means they're listening to the some another one's communication, okay, threatening or damage computer system. These are the types, okay, of the computer type. Hacking and cracking, okay, so these are the important bits in the computer crime. Okay, so first is a hacker. Hacker means one who gains unauthorized computer access but without doing the damage. Okay, and next one is the cracker, one who breaks into computer system for the purpose of doing the damage. Okay, so this is the major difference between the hacker and cracker. Okay, once hacker is not deal with the damage, okay, he is to use only the access, but cracker is the intention of doing the damage, okay, and for that he breaks the computer system. Okay, so this is the major difference between them. Again, some computer crimes are the data diddling, okay, and phishing, cloning, carding, picky banking, okay, social engineering. So these are the various types of the computer crimes. They are committed in the world, all over world. Okay, so these are the illegal tasks, and yes, the major role is the computer viruses and destructive code. Virus, as we are termed into the biological word, the virus, these in computer systems also, it is the virus, it spreads widely, okay, and it is nothing but one small disruptive program, okay, which is programmed, and that disrupts the normal functioning of a computer system, and it gets spread all over the networks, okay, and it gets spread very rapidly, and the program is containing the code for that one, okay, and this whatever the system containing this one is get collapsed, okay, and functioning like that is written into the program of the virus, okay, and some of the type are the worm, okay, the Trojan horses and logic or time bomb, okay, so the role of different viruses, okay, different types of viruses are different, okay, some may be more harmful, some are not that much, but they are playing their role various differently. Okay, so one question for you is that which are more secure, multi-word password and password mode using the combination of letters, numbers and symbols? So complex long passwords are better, but they are only useful in certain condition, but the complex password are enough to keep you protected, as you need to manage passwords safely using the password manager. Okay, turn on two-step authentication, it is important, and make sure that sensitive websites that you visit encrypted connection and keep your browser and software updated. Okay, so you have to deal with them. Next one is the computer security, the third term, and we have various safeguards. Okay, what you have to do is that you have to be ready with the security plan, okay, and break in do occur, okay, backup restoring, only allow access to the key employees, okay, change passwords frequently, okay, use antivirus software and use biometrics to access to the computer resources and hire trustworthy employees. These are the some terms you have to take care about to implement the security. Okay, and the encryption is the technical word here, the process of encoding the messages, okay, before they enter into the network, and it get decoded at the receiving end so that no one can steal that data. And yes, how encryption works, that keys are there in playing important role. Symmetric key means both sides are using the same key. Public key and private key means they are different, and it get transferred between them. Okay, and third one is the certificate authority is there, okay, it means on the particular websites, okay, the third party trusted middleman various verifies the website, okay, as the trusted one, and only the then SSL by the Netscape popular and public key encryption method. So you can use the firewall, okay, it deal with the intranet, and it is the combination of the hardware and software which kept unauthorized users apart from network system, okay. So virus prevention, for that what you have to do is that again make backups, install antiviruses and all that, delete unnecessary emails and all. You have to take care about these terms, okay. And yes, avoid cookies, visit sites as anonymous user, okay. So you have to take care about your privacy so that you can not be guessed, okay. So getting cons at various places like traveling, vacation spending, okay, webcamming and internet access and auctions, investment, healthcare products. Here are the various terms using which you maybe get trapped, okay. So you have to take care about in these situations. So these are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.